We shall be now discussing various models of blended learning. Now, when one goes through the literature, there are two different categories of classification of models of blended learning. In the first category, they are divided into four major types of blended learning. And in another category, they are divided into six major types of blended learning. First, we shall be discussing about the first classification, where they are divided into four different types. The four models are listed as rotation model, flex model, a la carte model, and the enrich virtual model. We will be discussing each of these models now, but in general, when one can say that as one moves from the rotation model to the enhanced virtual model, as the name suggests, we move more from face-to-face mode to more of onlineness. There is a blend of both face-to-face mode and online in each of the types. But as we move from the rotation model to the enhanced virtual model, the onlineness goes on increasing. So we shall be discussing each of these models now. First, we begin with the rotation model. Rotation model is very much similar to the face-to-face mode classroom. So it would remind many of us the typical pre-primary school classroom, where there are various activities kept in the class, and the teacher asks a group of students to do certain one activity while another group is asked to do another activity, and so on. In case of rotation model, the teacher decides that when the students would move from one activity to other, like the group would be moving from one activity to other. So this is the rotation. So the students keep on rotating in the various activities. In case of rotation model, there are four subtypes of this type of blended learning. The first one is a session rotation, then the lab rotation, then flipped classroom, and the fourth one is the individual rotation. So we shall see how they differ from one another. The first one is the session rotation. So this is very much a teacher controlled type of blended mode, where the teacher has designed maybe a large group interaction or a large group instruction, maybe a small group interaction, maybe some activity on the related to computer or internet. And she makes the students go from one station to another station in a sequential manner. Now the group of students would be divided differently for each station, and the students would be rotating from one station to another. Thus, the teacher has very much control over how the students are progressing in terms of their learning, how the students are engaged during their learning process, and so on. We move on to the next type, that is the lab rotation. So as the name suggests, there are laboratories or labs involved in this kind of a blended mode. So the labs could be a computer lab, could be physics lab, chemistry lab, or a biology lab, any other language lab also. So the students are to move from one lab to another, and one of these labs, they are given the opportunity to have the virtual kind of experience or an online kind of an experience. And thus, there is the blend of face-to-face mode and online mode. So the students may move from, say, physics lab, then they would go to the chemistry lab. The students who were already in the chemistry lab initially, they would further move to, say, language lab. The students from language lab, they would move to, say, computer lab. And thus, they on keep moving to the further place. So basically, here the learning is more focused through the laboratory kind of a situation. So the teacher here also has to take care that the content is such that which can be handled through this laboratory kind of a situation. So this is once again, in a way, a teacher control is to a considerable extent. We move to the third type, that is the flip classroom, which is once again a subtype of the rotation type of model of blended mode. In case of flip classroom, the teacher may give some common instructions to all, or maybe she has a common teaching session for all the students through face-to-face mode. But that is not sufficient. So she gives some activities for the students, which they conduct maybe through online mode or even at times even through face-to-face mode while the teacher is away. So here one can see both the attributes of having the teacher support is there for the students, as well as there is a possibility of having the learner autonomy for the students, and thus it can be flipped. Whatever the activities they do during their independent sessions or during the sessions when the teacher is not there, the output of it or the products of whatever they have done during that time slot, that is, they everything is shown to the teacher during the face-to-face mode, or at times they can even submit through online mode. There is possibility that they have certain doubts during this session where they are on their own without the teacher. Those doubts are also clarified by the teacher through the face-to-face mode when they meet next time. So thus the rotation between the face-to-face mode with the teacher and without the teacher session, this cycle keeps on continuing, and that is why it is called as the flip classroom. The fourth option in the rotation model is the individual rotation. Now, as the name suggests, here the learner's autonomy or the learner's decision about choosing a particular option comes in a big way. The options which we have seen earlier, where it was maybe station rotation or lab rotation, it was more or rather the decision by the teacher that which sequence to be followed by the students, how much time to be spent on at each point and so on. In this case, this is the individual's decision. Who is this individual now? This individual is a student. So the student decides that when do I want a face-to-face mode or when do I want to go for online mode, which part of the content I want to learn through online mode, how much time do I want to spend on this, what kind of resources do I want to see. So all the possibilities are made available to the student, but it is ultimately the student's decision. One more factor here one can note is, in case of say lab rotation or station rotation, it is more dealt where the students are young, where they may or may not be able to take the decision for what is best suited for them. For using the individual rotation kind of a model, this learner also needs to have that kind of a maturity to understand that which is the best possible mode for me to follow for this kind of a content, and to have that kind of an exploration with the resources that are available. When the student has that kind of a maturity, the teacher can make the option of learner rotation or individual rotation available to the students. Whereas when the students are not so mature to take this kind of a decision, maybe the earlier options like station rotation, lab rotation, which are more teacher controlled, would be used by the teacher. So here also you can see the gradation from the station rotation to the individual rotation. So these were the four types of the rotation model of the blended learning. Now from rotation model, we move to the next type of model, which is the flex model. In second kind of model of blended learning, that is the flex type, the students and the teachers, they interact through online mode but in a brick and mortar kind of institution away from the home. So their interactions are possible through maybe a large group interaction, or the teacher can divide the students in smaller group for small group interactions. But these interactions take place through online mode. The teacher here is able to see their products in terms of their discussions, or if whatever they have say designed at the end of their discussion, that everything is available online for the teacher to see, to comment on. This kind of a blended mode has the advantage of having the maximum of teacher's time for every student individually, and thus it is one of the popular model of blended learning. We go to the third type, that is called as the a la carte model of blended learning. Now in this kind of model, the learner autonomy is to a greater extent. The learner decides that what part of the syllabus one wants to learn through online mode and which part of the syllabus one wants to learn through the face-to-face mode. For example, a student can decide that I want to learn, say, something related to history through online mode, whereas whatever the face-to-face mode classes are available, I would like to attend the man and science classes from face-to-face mode. So here, as we see, the learner's autonomy of choosing the mode is gradually increasing, and in a la carte model, it is very, very obvious that this kind of autonomy and decision-making is given more to the learners. From here, we come to the last model, that is the enriched virtual model. Now, in this case, as the name suggests, it is the main focus is on the virtual mode, that is the online mode. And the main part of the online courses are made available to the students, and a very less part of it is available through the face-to-face mode. Many a times, the students, if they are, say, working or where they are able to take the responsibility of their own learning, they go for online mode classes, and where only when they need a small help from the teachers or there is a need of a smaller duration interaction with the teachers, then only to that extent the face-to-face mode component is added. Thus, we have discussed four different types of models of blended learning. We have discussed them one after the other. Now, here is in the diagram where they all four of them are put in under the same dimension or the same continuum, and we shall be seeing all four of them at one go so that we are better able to compare their attributes. So in this diagram, as you can see that on the x-axis there are brick and mortar nest, that is the face-to-face mode, and as one progresses further on the x-axis, it is more of the online nest is added. On the y-axis, the learner empowerment is to a lower extent. The time, pace, the place, path, everything, the freedom given to the learner is to a lower extent when one is closer to the x-axis. And when one starts moving away from the x-axis on the y-axis, all these factors are added to a higher extent on the blended learning models. And when all the four models that we have discussed up till now, when they are put on the continuum, you can see that at the basic level the rotation model comes. So here the features are that more of the brick and mortar interactions, that is the face-to-face interactions, are to a greater extent, and empowerment given to the learner or the learner autonomy is to a much lower extent. As one moves from rotation to flex to a la carte and then to enriched virtual model of blended learning, one can see that the online-ness goes on increasing with the face-to-face mode interaction getting to a minimal extent. When one reaches the enriched mode, interaction is to the least possible extent. And similarly, on the y-axis, when one moves from rotation to enriched virtual model, the learner autonomy goes on increasing from rotation to enriched virtual model. So from this diagram, you can see that while deciding which model to be used by the teacher needs to take into consideration especially two aspects. Number one is learner attributes, learner characteristics, and the second main part is the content, the type of content and the content characteristics. Because when the teacher decides to give the opportunity of having the enhanced virtual model or enriched virtual model to the students, then she should be sure that the learners are mature enough to make those decisions, and then they will be able to track their own learning path. So that was the very reason why we have shown all the four models in the form of a diagram, where all the four models are part of a single diagram and one is able to really see how they progress in terms of the learner autonomy and also in terms of going from face-to-face mode to the online mode. Here one has to remember a point that even if one moves to the enriched virtual model, which is having the maximal of the onlineness, it does not say zero or no face-to-face mode interaction. So even if it is the maximal, there is a component of small face-to-face mode interaction is there. It is of course up to the student or the learner if one wants to make use of it or otherwise. But the opportunity will be given for the learner to have that kind of an interaction. So thus the proportion of having the onlineness and having the face-to-face mode component would go on varying from the rotation to the enriched virtual model, but both the blends or both the modes will be definitely a part of the curricular transactions while teaching through blended mode.